Welcome. This is the Rock Cycle, a scheme we have already presented in previous clip. After having looked at magmatic rocks, we will focus now on metamorphic rocks. When a rock, whatever its origin, is exposed to high temperatures and pressures, it will be profoundly modified. A metamorphic rock is born. Do you want to see what metamorphic rocks look like? Take your backpack and go up into the mountains. There, you might find rocks which have been formed at depths of 10 or 20 kilometers and have come all the way up for you to collect. These rocks will be very different from the magmatic rocks we have seen in the previous clip and from the sedimentary rocks you will see in the next one. When tectonic plates converge towards each other, a large region of deformation occurs, where rocks are squeezed and deformed, typically at high temperatures. These temperatures can be of several hundred degrees and pressures in excess of 3 or 4 megapascal, which corresponds to the weight of a column of several kilometers of rocks. With higher temperatures, old minerals become unstable and new ones will form, providing very different aspects to the rock. When deformed at high pressures, the rock will develop a strong planar fabric and again will look very different. Changes of temperature with depth are described by geothermal gradients. We define a gradient characterized by high temperatures and low pressure, contact metamorphism in the figure. We define a regional one with intermediate values called regional metamorphism, and one with very low temperatures even at high depths, named blue schists. Different types of metamorphic rocks form under these different gradients. Regional metamorphism is found in the areas where two lithospheric plates collide with each other, there where mountains form. This is the most common form of metamorphism. A sand or a shale brought at higher depths will first become a green schist, will then acquire a coarser size and eventually becoming a gneiss. At higher temperatures, it might even start melting, creating migmatites. Gradients in subduction zones are characterized at much higher pressures and result in very special rocks, blue schists. Famous examples are found in the Alps, in Japan, and in many other mountain belts. In these settings, rocks reach depths of several tens of kilometers and then, even more strangely, are brought back to the surface. On the opposite side, we find gradients characterized by very high temperatures at shallow depths. This is the case, for instance, of magma chamber. The rocks will be warmed up and cooked with little deformation and a lot of fluid interactions. Intense deformation at high pressures and temperatures is often coupled with circulation of hot fluids. These are key for the formation of ore minerals. We have followed rocks down to large depths where they have been modified and metamorphosed. Some rocks will start moving upward, thereby uplifting the surface of the Earth and creating mountains. These are the source of some of the most important types of sedimentary rocks, the third type of rock forming the outer part of the Earth, which we will look at in the next clip.